Good morning, Year 6, and welcome to your maths lesson for Thursday the 4th of June. And this is all about equivalent fractions, decimals and percentages. So pause the video to get the equipment that you need. So your flashback starter is going to come up next. Remember, these are concepts that we've already gone through, so it should be revision. There will be two slides, so you will need to pause on each one just to give you time to do those. Well done, doing really well so far. So you'll need to pause the next slide just so you can see the answers and mark those yourself, and just do as we would do in class. If you get any wrong, go back and just try and figure out why. If you need to do a little bit extra work on that concept, that's fine. So far we've looked at decimals as fractions. Yesterday we looked at fractions and percentages, and today we're going to be combining all three together. So looking at equivalent fractions, decimals and percentages. Okay, so we are looking today at fractions, decimals and percentages together. So we're going to have a look at this 100 square in front of us. So we've got one square shaded in. So we can say that is either 1 out of 100, we can say it's 1/100th, and we know that as a decimal, to write that 1/100th in the 1/100th column, we write it as 0.01. So how would you write that then as a percentage? Think about how many out of 100 it is. And hopefully you realise that that would be written as 1% because it's 1 out of 100. Okay, let's have a look at this one. On the slide, how would you write that as a fraction, decimal and percentage? Pause the video if you need to. So for this one, we should be able to recognise that this is 10 out of 100. Have a think, how would we write that as a decimal? Well, we've got 10/100ths, which means I write that into the hundredths column. So I could write 10, or I can just leave it as 0.1. And then how would I write that as a percentage as well? So remember, it's 10 out of 100. And hopefully we remembered that that would be 10%, 10 out of 100. Okay, so I'll have a look at the question on the screen and see if you can have a go at this. Pause the video. Okay, so I'm going to work left to right, but it doesn't matter which way you go. So we know that it's 56 out of 100 as a fraction. So as a decimal, I know that's 56/100ths. So I'm going to write 0.56, 56/100ths. And then as a percent, I know it's 56 out of 100, which must mean that it's 56%. Great work. So if you now have a go at the questions below that and pause the video so you can do that. Great. If we look at the second one first then, so you had 97%, which you should have realised is the same as 97 over 100, which we can then write as 97/100ths, so 0.97. And then for the bottom one, it was 0.33, so that means 33/100ths, which we can write as 33 over 100, which must mean that it's then 33%. Okay, if you now have a go at the question on the board, you'll notice this one, you need to make an equivalent fraction for the middle one. Pause the video if you need to. Okay, so for this one then, you knew it was 4/5. So how do we turn 4/5 into a fraction out of 100? Well, to turn 5 into 100, you do times 20. And you do exactly the same to the numerator. So 4 times 20 becomes 80. So your fraction is then 80 out of 100. Now you turn that into a decimal, that becomes 80 hundredths. So 0.80 or 0.8 is absolutely fine. And then it's a percentage, that then becomes 80%. Great, working really well so far, Year 6. If you now have a go at the two questions below that, so pause the video so you can do that. Great, so for the second one, we had that it was 75 hundredths as a decimal, which we can then turn into a fraction of 75 over 100, which we should know is 3/4, but if we didn't, we could use our common factor of 5 to figure that out. Our common factor of 25. And then we should know that that is then 75%. And then for the bottom one, so you knew that it was 30%. So you can then turn that into 30 hundredths, which then becomes a 0.3. And you can see on that one, on the fraction, next to 30 out of 100, it's also got there 3/10. Why do you think that's been done? Hopefully you recognise that's just because it's the most simplified version of the fraction. Well done, yes. So you've worked really hard, Year 6. I'd like you to now have a go at converting 9% into a fraction and a decimal, and 0.3 into a decimal and a percentage. So pause the video so you can have a go at that. Okay, so if we take 9% first, if I write that as a fraction, that can then be 9 hundredths. And then if I then take that to a decimal, well, 9 hundredths, I write that as none in the ones column, decimal point, none in the tenths column, and 9 in the hundredths column. So it becomes 0.09. And then if I look at 0.3, so that's as a decimal, which means that that is 3/10. So to write that as a fraction, I can write 3/10. At present, that doesn't really help me with my percentage because my percentage needs to be out of 100. So how could I turn this fraction into out of 100? We should have realised that I can multiply it by 10. So 10 times 10 is 100. And 3 times 10 is 30. So I've now got my fraction of 30 out of 100, which I know then becomes 30%. Great, you've worked really hard, Year 6, today, and you should now be able to have a go at question 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So pause the video so you can do that. And then at the end, once you've finished those, there's going to be a little bit of problem solving. So pause the video to do questions 1 to 5. Great, you've worked really hard. So if we just have a little look at the problem solving, we've got four children were completing some maths work. Put the children in order of who got the most correct. So the first one got 17 out of 20 correct. Second one got 84% correct. Third one got 0.8 correct. And the last one got 12% incorrect. So let's have a think about what we need to work out here. What do we need to make the same and what can we work with? So pause the video so you can have a think about that. If you are a little bit stuck, have a think. Do you want to turn them into fractions, decimals, or percentages so you can compare? Okay, so here we've got the answers no matter which way you converted them. So whether you converted them into fractions, decimals, or percentages. So the first thing really to recognise is that the bottom one, the comparisons are different because the first person is correct, second person's correct, third is correct, the last one's incorrect. So I would suggest turning that into correct first, which instead of 12% incorrect, comes 88% correct. So from there, you could have either turned them into equivalent fractions for all of them. You could have maybe turned them into decimals, or you could have turned them into percentages. You might have done all three. And there are your answers if you want to just check. And then in terms of who got the most correct, well, the bottom person got the most correct because they got 88% correct. In second place was the top person, so 85 out of 100, so 85% correct. The person on the second row was third with 84%. And then the person on the third row was last with 80%. So if you could now have a go at the question on the slide. So I'm thinking of a fraction. Can you guess what it is? It's less than 73%. It's greater than 0.4. And it has a denominator of 5. You might need to do quite a bit of jotting and working out here. It may be that you even come across some trial and error. So pause the video so you can have a go. Okay, so we're going to go through the answers, so if you're not out of time, please do pause your video. So I'm going to think about the things I know. Well, it's less than 73%, it's greater than 0.4, and it's a denominator of 5. So let's start with that first of all. So I'm going to go, first of all, from 5 over 5. So just think about 5 out of 5 as a fraction and as a percent. What would that be as a percent? 5 out of 5. Hopefully you realise that 5 out of 5 is a whole. So a whole of something as a percent is 100%. Well, it can't be that because it's less than 73%. So it can't be 5 out of 5. So what it might be, if I work backwards, 4/5. 3/5, 2/5, or 1/5. So just using that logic at present, they're what it might be. Okay, so from here, what I'm going to do next is convert them into fractions. And once I've got them into fractions, I can then turn them into percentages. So 4/5, well, if I times 5 by 20, that gets me 100. And do the same to 4, which becomes 80. Have to think about what the others will be, just by switching pens. So 3/5, so that would be out of 100. So 5 times 20, 3 times 20, 60. 5 times 20 is 100. 2 times 20 is 40. And then 1/5, so that becomes out of 100. 1 times 20 is 20. So I've now got 20 hundredths, 40 hundredths, 60 hundredths, and 80 hundredths. Have a think about what they are as percentages. So as percentages, that would be 20%, 40%, 60%, and 80%. Now, if I go back to my question, it says it's less than 73%. So there's no way that it can be this one. So it can't be 80%, which was 4/5, because that's larger than 73%. Could still possibly be the rest. We're going to break it down and look even further. Okay, so we're now going to look at the last bit of the question, which looks at decimals. So it's greater than 0.4. So I'm going to turn these last three into decimals. Well, if I've got 20 hundredths, that's exactly the same as saying 2/10. So I can write 0.2 there as a decimal. And if 20% is 0.2, what is 40% as a decimal? And we should realise that that is 0.4. And then the last one, 60% is 0.6. Well, let's go back to the question. It's greater than 0.4. Well, greater means that it's bigger. So it can't be this one. It can't be 2/5 because that was 0.4. And it can't be 0.2, which was 1/5. So it must be this one. So if we go back to our question, I'm thinking of a fraction. Can you guess what it is? Well, it's all of this as decimals and percentages. But as a fraction, our most simplified version would be 3/5. And I've just put a clear version of that for you on the screen, just so you can have a good look at it. So you should now be able to go have a go at question 6 and 7. You have done a fantastic job today, Year 6. Well done. The next slide will show the answers, so if you are not ready for these, please pause the video. If you are, it'll move straight on. And as always, please self-mark, and if you do realise that you've made any mistakes, go back and see why. If you feel like you need to, you can watch parts of the video again as well. You have worked so hard today, Year 6. I look forward to seeing all of your work on Seesaw.